crush you. Oh, fuck.
Let me crush you.
Never mind.
Yo.
Alright, so I think we're going to get this started. Let me just hopefully type in this guy's name correctly. It'd be so much easier if I had a bloody keyboard.
Yeah. Alright, do you know what Armand's PSN is?
Yeah, well, Hassan just wrote it in the chat, so...
Okay, yeah, let me invite him then.
I just hopefully done that and it should be him. And let me get... the other guy.
So do you know anything about the Spanish guy?
I don't know, is he being like a troll and putting my name or something?
I have no clue. Oh wait, he's already in here and he's sending an invite, whatever.
Yeah, I'm just looking for the other guy. Alright. Cool, alright. So we should hopefully get the first game. Where's Finger Demolition from? Because Bull Rage is now starting to bug my phone because I stopped him from eating dinner.
I think he might be from Germany.
Alright.
But I'm not 100% sure, because there's other guy called Finger Drums. I don't know if they're from the same place. Yeah, but I was in Germany as well.
Alright, that's cool. So we're just,
there we go.
Alright, so I guess, let me just change that and we're gonna get this first one all started and on the road.
Yep. What's your connection do you have to Armand's?
One bar. But I think it's one of those false ones, I'm hoping.
Yeah.
Well, I guess when they, do a test. Who's banning Villa?
That was Fergus.
Fergus, stop it.
Typical Fergus always tells him like it. Alright, so the test match should be going underway.
Alright, so...
Apparently Armand's sister is on Skype, so his connection might be crap.
Yep. Alright, well... I didn't see any of these guys play yesterday. Did you happen to... Well, when did they play, actually?
I saw Armand's playing against Hassan. He did, like, way better than expected. He's actually pretty good. I haven't seen him play before.
Oh,
that.
Yeah, I did watch that match, yeah.
Yeah, but I know absolutely nothing about W3S.
Nah, that's what I'm saying. This tournament is very interesting. Definitely the chance to see new players that maybe not would have chances to go to tournaments.
Yeah.
So we're just going to have a mass connection test. Well, he's got the wavy, so...
Yeah, could be interesting.
Yeah, that's good. The connection looks alright, hopefully. Alright, just don't keep it too long, guys.
Yeah, they don't play an actual match.
Alright, yes, your tag crush is working. Yes, you got that. Alright, yeah, that's it. Alright, yeah, thanks.
Okay, good. I was afraid for a second when you tag crashed.
So, this is going to be very interesting. Oh, gosh. Why don't people just... just keep doing one plus...
Back to one.
Do you opt for... Oh, God.
Oh, why you gotta go for combos? Just hit him with a string.
Unblockable, she's got unblockable. Go forward, 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 whatever that kick is, that step move, it'll take a lot. Can you get full screen? Yeah, of course you're gonna get full screen when the match starts. Don't worry. feels laggy but playable. Listen, I'm not a noob. Of course I'm going to change it to full screen. It's a test match. Do you not want to see the test match in full screen? Do you not want me to want the test match in full screen? Like, come on, guys. What do you... Oh, you're not happy
no,
with
the... No, Armin does not like it.
I don't even know. Is the connection that bad?
It might just be like delay because it wasn't stuttering, but it might just be delay lag.
So one said it's playable, but a bit laggy. But that's online. That's how online's gonna be. It's not gonna be perfect. It's always gonna be that delay.
Armand is gonna play.
Let's play. Okay. Okay, we're gonna have to do the whole rotation again.
I wish you could just skip your turn.
Yeah, hopefully they put that in. Well, I guess this lobby wasn't meant to be used like this, but who knows.
Yeah, it was way worse in Tekken 6. Do you remember that? If you played online in Tekken 6.
You know what, but when I was playing Tekken 6, I didn't really even know what the hell offline and online, like, I didn't know anything.
Yeah.
I was just like, oh, just press the button. But yeah, definitely now.
Like Tekken 6, if you didn't take your turn, it would still force you to play.
Would it?
Yeah, like if you wait out the 15 seconds, it would just like start the match instead of going to the next guy.
Wow, I didn't even know that.
It was proper messed up.
So, are we going to start this match, get this match going first to three guys? Yes!
Alright, let's go.
So, we're going to have our first match, and for you people that are complaining and moaning, look, I'm going to switch it to full screen. You guys. You guys, man, come on. So, this is going to be very interesting. I actually do remember Armand playing yesterday, playing against Hassan, and he didn't do too bad, from what I remember.
Yeah, he was playing pretty well. Like, I've never seen him play before that, so I was rather surprised at how good he was.
And he's going for team... I'm just going to call him DS, because that's just so much easier. He's going for team JDCR. This team has already proven to be very strong, so... You know, it's one international.
He had a nice wave dash earlier. I just wonder if he has the same move backwards.
So they're going all the way to Palais Francais. Big whiff on the running three. But I guess, I guess this is still early. They're still trying to feed each other out.
He could have launched that downboard 1-1-2.
Oh, yeah. You mean, well, yeah. Actually, no. Not M. Forest. Nice start there. Goes into a nice bound. So this is bad. Oh, because yeah, went for the tag. Ooh, that's a shoulder. He went for the tag crash bait there, but Armand did see it and so decided to tag him, which is very good. Just runs in. Nice back block on the down back three. Goes for the Kazemi.
Doesn't get to play.
Ooh, DSS. I love it.
Legend kick.
I don't know what happened there. Did he mess up his DSS? Wow, the end of that round was a bit odd. Okay, well, there we go. Just ran out and missed.
Oh, just random.
I think I was supposed to be, what's going on? I think I was supposed to be, capital punishment. That's a nice DSS combo right there. Messes up his DSS there. I think went for a three. He
missed the back for three. That's almost dead.
There we go, now the rush. Ooh, that's the last hit. Ooh, straight split kicks. Is this gonna go to the wall, big damage? Got Ox for the legend kick. Tries to catch him possession with a back three. Nice, down four. Ooh, it's starting to lag a bit, isn't it?
Yeah. Stuttering quite a bit.
Yeah.
D3 is pushing quite a few buttons on defense. He's not really moving a lot. He's doing Hayaki down back one plus two a lot and crouch punches.
Unlucky there, the pick up. Didn't get the pick up. Ooh,
just
flip kicked again. Just gonna go to the wall. Unlucky on the DSS there. That combo's quite hard to do. Doesn't duck the last hit. Wow, just hop kick the.
That was sick.
I don't know what's going on. Misses the jab. I wonder if it's maybe it is really delayed, because I don't know, it seems a bit off this map. Dark as any, breaks the chain throw and brings in a forest floor.
Ooh, his shoulders in.
Yeah, that was just Raggle, he was just gonna do it. Goes
no punish.
Should have got a hop kick, come on, hop kick. Oh, yeah,
that was the third time for charm.
I
don't think Armin is liking his connection, you can see.
This is a...
I think we might have to postpone this point.
Yeah, I don't think it's a proper match anymore. See, that's the thing with one.
We have Wolf Rage and Finger Drums, right? Like, both in the chat.
Say that again?
I think we have Finger Demolition, Finger Demolition and Wolf Rage both in the chat, right?
Lucky boss. Yeah, I guess they're gonna have to come back and do that match again later, because
that's just not playable.
Hold on, 2 seconds while I just cast Bull Ridge.
Alright.
Ah, Finger Demo is in the chat. Okay, that's good. Alright, I'm gonna just do this on my own accord to get the next match going.
Yeah. What? Can't really play on this.
Okay, so we're gonna have up next Finger Demolition against one of my good friends, frenemy, or call him nemesis rival. Yeah, he's a nemesis and rival.
Okay.
I'm just gonna kick them two now. Yeah, they're gonna. I believe we'll get kicked. Right, they left. Alright, friend of mine. So we're gonna invite the bully himself, the online.
The
online warrior. Alright, so it's just Finger Demolition. Cool. We're gonna enter that right now. So this is gonna be very interesting to see, because obviously I know Bull Rage quite well in his playstyle. So it's gonna be interesting to see him play someone else and analyze this match, because obviously when I play him, I think certain things. And Finger Demolition, I actually didn't get to see his match, so I don't know who he plays, you know, what team he runs, so it's going to be interesting, and it's going to be interesting to see if Bull Rage actually goes for his main team of Stevu and Jack.
Yeah. I hear Bull Rage also very aggressive. I haven't seen him play that much.
Bull Rage, he is definitely very aggressive, in my opinion. He may call it something else, but I feel he is a quite aggressive player, man. So it should be very interesting, because Steve and aggression, I think, go well hand in hand. Steve can definitely really rush you down. Bull Rage, press X. Bull Rage, press X.
I won't have to wait another rotation.
Please press X. He done that on purpose.
Just trolling.
Yeah, this is a trial match. Let me take it off full screen and upset people. So, I actually, looking at Finger Demolition's team, I actually think I do remember him playing, and I don't think he played Armor King and someone else. I don't think he actually played Dragunov with the Armor King.
It wasn't a Dragunov.
He played Dragunov and Paul, and then Dragunov for Armor King. I think that was the guy that was switching, or am I going crazy?
Oh wait, I remember playing him in an online tournament, I think. Yeah. I think he switches it up a bit. He uses Dragunov and Paul and Dragunov and someone else. I forgot who the other character was.
Yeah, so his team is definitely he wants to be a hard hitter, definitely. That it seems he lacks that power. Bull Rage, I know personally, has he's been around this game for time. He's been a high level player, though I say that through the grits of my teeth, for a very long time. So he definitely is one with tournament experience. He actually has beaten Just Frame Dreams as well in. Yeah, there's a match that he had with Justin James, and he actually beat Justin James in Tekken 6. So he is definitely no slouch at all. He is someone that really knows how to play, knows what he's doing, knows the game, played it for many years. So yeah, and we've got some blue sparks. Is that mind game? I love doing that kind of stuff in button tests, showing I can execute wave dash. But yeah, that's end the match. So are we gonna have a silly? Oh, right, yeah. So I guess the connection's good. It's gonna end the match.
Fight. They're both running into each other. Off the bat, just try to take control of the game and go on offense.
Yeah, I know that's kind of Bull Rage's style anyway. Oh, fuck's sake. I know that's Bull Rage's style really. I know he likes the offense. He likes to get offensive. So, whether it's Can Finger Demolition, I think this match is going to go, Can Finger Demolition handle his offense, and can he handle Steve? Now, Steve is a character, definitely. If you don't know how to play against Steve, it can be a problem with counter hits, because you may press a button out of, you know, when you shouldn't press a button, and Steve can't hit. He's a can't hit character, basically.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
And you don't need can't hit with Steve, because that's where Steve gets all his damage from. Mm. So
just poke your way, try to annoy you, and then try to score that counter hit.
Yeah, oh my gosh, why did he go for the long one? He had that much health, and he went for the longest unlockable in the last minute. Do people not know how to test? Lucky boss! Oh, God. But anyway, now that test match is done, we can hopefully get this match going. Okay, well, Bora just stayed on X, so I guess we're really going to get this show on the road. So, let me not upset the people and put it back to full screen, because I know how you get upset now.
Yeah.
It lagged for a moment. Yeah, I guess there are spikes.
That's not like.
Spikes are just spikes, so.
Okay, we good.
Yeah, so this is gonna be a really, really interesting match. I'm looking forward to this. Like I said, Bull Rage is a good friend, so it's always nice to see, you know, good friends play and see how he's gonna do in this match.
For sure.
So, like I said, I don't, you know, Finger Demolition. So, it's going to be interesting to see who he picks and how he goes about dealing with Steve, if Bull Rage picks Steve. So,
yeah, he might just go for a different team the first match.
Yeah, Bull Rage definitely, he can play a lot of characters. He can play, he plays a decent Ganryu. I hate to say it, his pool. His pool's alright. It's okay. Yeah, he's got a good pool. And yeah, like I said, he's been around for many years in this game and has been at a high level. He's made a name for himself, you know, he's got combo videos out. I don't want to ride this guy too much. So yeah, he's gone with Prototype Jack and Dr. B.
Gonna see some trolling right now.
I wouldn't actually call this trolling, because he does play this team. I've played him against him and this team. And Dr. B is definitely a spanner in the works, let's say that. No, not many people know Dr. B. I don't know Dr. B now.
Still, I have no clue.
Yeah, no clue. So, we've got the nice... Ooh, that's going to be dead. And that's perfect, and he goes with a crane throw.
That crane used to be so dumb.
Yeah, when the game came out. So, it starts off the the round with a down back three. So now he's got tags in and sits down. So I wonder if Demolition's gonna know any ways that Bull Rage tags in, and how, you know, his options of tagging catches the counter hit there.
conversion, though.
Yeah, Demolition Man doing quite well this round. Got the last lead. Got Bull Rays really pressured. Ooh, see, yep. I can't even commentate Dr. B. I don't know if anything was guaranteed in the back.
I have no clue.
I don't know what that was. Is that a holding move? High, low? I don't know. Ooh. Yeah, he could have had to pull a 2 the dark upper, but you know, nice throw. This is good pressure now. Jack is can't step it in this position. This is really bad position for Jack to be in. But Tyson Dr. B, lucky he didn't get full splat there. And
Ooh, nice punish.
And is this going to be dead? See, I don't know the combo damage of this team. Nice tech bait. So he does know tech with his team.
Yeah.
I guess that was guaranteed.
Oh, we got the butt slide from there.
Yeah, just butt slide to backward slide to laying on the floor. And I'm guessing that's a downboard one.
Yeah, it looks like a handshake.
Yeah. And Bull Rage from being behind in that match really came through. I wonder how much damage is this crane? Oh, that's actually good. It puts him back in towards the wall, that crane. So, good option, I guess.
Yeah.
See, and I was saying this before the tournament started. Will people use customizations? I'd wonder, because I was watching a gym player once. I was wondering, would he put the fan on? So, I guess it's liable. Nice 1 plus 2 break there.
Yeah, I know someone was using the fan earlier today. I forgot who it was.
And
oh wow, just finishes him off with that move. That move's not funny.
I don't even know what is that move.
That's a sit one. It's like the mid mix up part was that's like.
Yeah, I don't even know if that's safe or I don't know, but that's 1-0 to Bull Rage. There was the Finger Demolition shouldn't get this on because there was that second round that he did have. He did really, he took it to Bull Rage and Bull Rage just made a good comeback. It could definitely be just be, you know, first game starters and and Dr. B, we don't see Dr. B at all.
Yeah, exactly.
let
alone seriously.
Yeah, it's hard to commentate. I don't know what's punishable. It all looks like gibberish to me. But yeah, that is 1-0 to Bull Rage. Bull Rage looking strong. So I wonder if Finger Demolition is going to make a switch, because I'm sure he was the one that did play pool, switched out Armor King for pool yesterday. So I wonder if he'll make a change here. Yeah. So Bull Rage in the chat asking if you can change teams. Nope, it's tournament rules. You can only change when you lose.
Yeah, I reckon Finger Demo, he was just far too passive that game. And he just doesn't know what Dr. B was doing. So he just needs to go in.
Yeah, definitely. That's one of the things I tend to do. If I don't know a character,
get ready for the next.
I have two things in my mind. I want to run into that character and take him out as quick as possible. Put them in a bad situation where they want to tag crash. And get in the more comfortable opportunity, more comfortable character. Because people need to remember this game, it's only one character that needs to dead. It's not Marvel. You don't need to kill the whole team.
Exactly.
So we've got Elvis prototype Jack here. Ooh, downboard too, straight there. Is this going to go to the wall? Nice bounce. And ooh, that's unlucky there. And Bullwhip, that's a lovely conversion there. And we got Iron Man. Wow, Iron Man and Elvis. What a team, man. They got Bull Rage with the gimmicks and stuff. Wow. I don't know.
Yeah, so that's a launcher 4-4-4 that you got on a good break.
That's a good break, and got Armor King back against the wall, but he's got Rage there. Ooh, that's a nice dark.
Ooh, dark upper. Is that going to be it?
Nah, I don't think so. He's going to have that pick through.
That could have been it.
Ooh. Bull Rage was ducking and got thrown. Must have pressed the while standing there.
Yeah.
Wow, just run up down.
No fear.
What's the wall combo with this team? Ooh, now this is a...
Whoa! That was
very interesting. It worked. Nice twist punch there with the 2-1 and the down 4. The Jack,
going
Jack...
safe with that down 4.
Yeah. I wonder if down 4 is like Jack's down 4, as in it's safe, because his legs aren't as long, so I wonder if it pushed him back as far.
Yeah, and his legs are there still as well. I thought it was only his arms.
There you go, the crane again. Throw him back against the wall. That crane's actually really good. Frozen back against the wall creates a little bit of space as well. So I think hanging in.
You understand what? Oh wow!
We've got to. We got to block that.
People just rather do a regular ender, because you want to be close up at the wall with Jack and just put them in that full catch mix up.
Yeah, that's true. Go for that 4-2.
Whoa.
Sidestep 2 catches him out of the air and ends it with down forward 1. So Bure is definitely looking really strong with his team. I wonder if he's going to play Steve at all.
Well, not if you win this match.
Nice punish there. Bure didn't check the combo, saw that it dropped. Woo! Oh, it doesn't convert.
Must have gotten surprised
that
hit.
Yeah. What? Yeah, I guess
so. Oh, wow, he's stuck.
Semi gold, block to B shenanigans, nice tagging. And see, I don't know what. Was that counter hit? Was that normal?
That was counter hit, yeah. That's a counter hit launcher. He was just off axis. He couldn't convert off it.
He seems to know quite a bit about Dr. B.
Yeah, I've never seen a Dr. B like actually punish people properly. This is weird.
And yeah, gets floated out of whatever that move was.
Yeah, I'm not sure what that was.
Yeah, so we got Big Way Jackin, Elvis Presley, and goes for the launch roll. Is this gonna be dead? Or the doesn't get the bounce. This is a bad position for Army King. That down back one was actually a punish. But yeah, Bure's
looking very comfortable.
Very comfortable, yeah. He was. Every time I see Bure go down to a deficit, he seems to claw it back.
Yeah.
So this
he just
is...
goes in like he doesn't show any fear. Like several times he's gone in and like done like a down 4-2 or something.
That's definitely one thing about Bure is once Bure is in his comfort zone, it is hard to get him out of his comfort zone. It can be done. Don't get me wrong, but. Bure in his comfort zone is, I think, very strong. I've seen him take out top guys back in the day when he's in his comfort zone.
Yeah, he's just one of those momentum-based players that's really hard to deal with when he gets going.
Definitely very momentum-based. And he's riding his momentum at the moment. He's two games up with Dr. B, which is a surprise to me. I guess he's saving his Steve for when he feels he needs to bring it out. I guess that's good. He knows that people are watching, so yeah.
Who is his main? Is it Steven Gannery or Steven Jack?
I would say Steven Jack, but he does play Steven Marduk. He does have a few really strong characters. He does play a good Gannery, good pool. Uses Gannery and pool sometimes. So yeah, he has quite a good arsenal of team.
Yeah, speaking of Paul, we could see Finger Demolition possibly bring Paul up.
Yeah. Well, we'll see, actually. Maybe, I guess he could go all out now and just... Battle. No, he sticks with the main team.
I think that's a good choice, because he's been putting a lot of work in with Armor King. Maybe he could have switched out Dragunov, but I don't know how comfortable he is with a Paul Armor King.
Yeah, definitely analyzing the last two matches, thinking back, he needs to start abusing down to Dragunov. It is so good with Dragunov. You can really frustrate an opponent with just down two.
Definitely.
So we're going to America with the Marvel stage.
Nice whip swing.
And he's got combo. Drops a combo. I wonder if that's nerves. Nice throw break there. Yeah, I wonder if he thought the homing move was coming. Wow, mid-screen frame, yeah? Alright, and that was to the wall. That's kind of good. Doesn't convert off of the tag
in. Yeah.
Oh, nice throw mix-up there. People would expect the giant swing from that position, so that was a nice mix-up. Blocks the down back three. Oh, unlucky right there. Doesn't get the right combo. I don't know.
That position when Dr. B hits you a down four and he tries to mix up whatever stance he ends up in initially, he has like a low slide, which is four, and the three is the launch and kick. But the three has really bad range, so if you backdash one thing, other good.
Yeah, I'll probably get hit by everything. I don't know what's going on. Doesn't punish the half circle too. Our boy is with nice pressure and a nice 4-2 on count here right there. If that was Tekken 7, he'll get that big beat.
That's so ridiculous.
Tombstone.
Return the favor.
He's gonna. No, he's gonna have to get Dragon off in. No, he's got Dragon off in nicely. Goes for the 1 plus 2 throw. I think that was a reaction to the throw.
Yeah.
Step with him. Guaranteed. Ooh, nice option. Unlucky. Unlucky, because he did roll back.
You don't want to be against the wall against Rage
And that is the bad situation. Yeah, full crouch down back front of the wall. Once you get hit by that, it's GG's really. You have very limited options. That plus that what?
That's just wall combo.
What was that? I don't know.
That's like his highest damage wall combo where he's in the Rage Hit position.
And again, we've got a nice Rage Dragon off.
Oh, wow, what? Under the 4-4. This thing is amazing.
Wow. Amazing. Unlucky.
I know Raven can go under, but like, T-Jack's pretty big.
Yeah, that was quite amazing. I don't know how that happened. This game sometimes does amazing things. Nice, just punish on the down forward too. And he should take this if he just ends it. Yeah, I was going to say, just end it with a slash kick. Or even the barge. So yeah, finger damage, got a match on the board there. Woo! Down, that, wow. He down forward the capital punishment. That's amazing. Walks into dark upper. This gonna go to the wall? That was a... Wow, unlucky. That was a really nice combo to actually get the break.
Yep.
Oh,
he dropped it.
It's lagging. That was a really unfortunate lag spike. Because that was the game-winning combo. I actually don't know how to rule that. But I guess they're going to continue. That's what I can say is, I don't know what that was. You've got always now messing about, I guess. I don't know if this is genuine tactics. Yep. Nice. Slamming on the floor. And Dr. Down that three. Second time he's got that. He's going to go for the Kazemi. I guess that's a... Oh, cause they'd be off of that hit.
Oh no, that's guaranteed.
Oh, it's guaranteed. Wow.
Yeah. Ooh. He's catching the down for free.
So he's
raw shoulders.
Ooh, unlucky. He's got that pixel of health. Brings an armor king. Ah, bullish. That's an old technique. And that's gonna be dead. That was very unlucky. That is a very common setup. I guess to the newer perk people that would work, but Bullray is just being on the block.
Yeah, I feel like he should have scouted that before, because two times before already Bullray has ducked in that situation.
So, okay. That was GG's.
Yep.
And I think Bully's actually going to stay. Oh, sorry. Bullray is going to actually stay. Don't go. And we're going to have... Go straight into Bull Rage versus Lucky Roll. Now, this.
Oh, Steve versus Steve.
This is going to be very interesting because I know. One more match, man. It's ready right now. So, yeah, like I was saying, Lucky Roll is definitely a player I play against him very frequently, and I personally think that he is the best I think he could potentially be one of the best up north. I think people don't know about him, and he's really underrated, like unslept on.
Definitely, like the first time I saw him play was like 2 days ago in this tournament.
Yeah.
From what I saw, he seems to have a different playstyle with Steve. He seems to be the more patient Steve that just, try to scout you out and then put in the counter hit.
Yeah, he's definitely, I really reckon he's gonna, really prosper as time goes on. I've trained with him, well, I play with him regularly. Like, I say on PSN, he's the one that I play the most. And watching him from how he used to be to how he is now, it's very impressive. And I know he's also played with Bull Rage a lot, definitely in Tekken 6. That's how I actually got that his PSN through Bull Rage, in lobbies with him. So these two know each other, these two play each other, they have played each other. So this may be a game where it's not only now they're playing Tekken, they're going to be playing mind games, like, you know, I know this guy likes to do this and he can't do this.
Yeah, that's always interesting to see.
Yeah. So this match is definitely going to be really really interesting, definitely for me, as obviously I know both these guys, so
yeah.
I wonder if
do you have him on your friend list?
Yeah, I'm inviting him now. I'm wondering if Bullrage is going to stick with his silly team. Yeah, I'm going to call it a silly team. I don't care. The team's silly.
I really want to see Steve versus Steve. It's going to be interesting, like, seeing the two different styles.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely they have different styles of Steve, and that's speaking from personal experience. Bullrage is definitely the more aggressive, I'm going to hunt you down, Steve. And Rel, he plays very patient, and I would say he plays very by the book and presses when he should press, and he definitely knows. And
yeah,
because this is me, and Miguel as well, very strong anchor to have behind you, because Miguel, although this game in quotations doesn't have a combat factor, Miguel on Rage is level 3 X Factor. That's what it is.
Yeah,
that's
Miguel Rage is, it's great fun.
It's level 3 X Factor. Activated, Wesker. Not Wesker. what's the other
taking
guy?
Glasses off.
Yeah, it is level 3 Wesker. What's the other one? Virgil, that's it. That is Virgil. Yeah. Right there. So, we're going to do a test match. Yeah, I'm glad Lucky Roll knows the protocol. I'm sure these two... the test match should be really quick. I know these two are both in the UK, so should be an alright connection. So, this is definitely gonna be a match that I've been interested to see.
Yeah, this is gonna be interesting for sure.
So, stream. Let's say what's up to the stream. I've been talking a lot. What do you think? Obviously, you just seen Bullrage play, and I hope some of you, or many of you, may know Rel and seen him play. So, what's your bets? Place your bets. One for Bull Rage and two for Rel. I want to see some ones and twos. No one put no five Haroon, because I know Haroon tries to be a funny guy. No five.
Haroon's
no,
five.
Yeah, no funny stuff, Haroon.
You know there's going to be bare five now just because he said that.
Alright, hold on 2 seconds. I just need to go.
Alright. Yeah, we got some ones. We got a two. Right now, it's just going to be a test match, so we have different teams coming out.
Yeah, sorry about that. I don't want to have a Keegan moment where I'm getting my dinner's ready shouted out to me.
Pick up the phone. Counting on you
for backup. Yeah, you don't want that moment. Round one. So yeah, we're just getting the test reared. Have a nice wave, that's the block. Ooh, instant one in freeze. Oh, the sidestep mind games.
Yo, that was slick.
Yeah. Okay, I think that's good.
Round two. Yeah.
So, this. Alright, someone must have the unblockable. Oh, God. Can you not do like the forward? Ha! The forward. Why do people not know the characters and just do a big hit and move? Why are you doing shitty ha-ha stuff? Oh my god. People do not know what test match is. Why are you... I know he's got big strings. Oh. Down four.
Oh, man.
Oh, gosh. Boy, swear down, man. You suck at test matching. You got Ganryu just running twos. Just got one, man. Why is he...
People... You know he's just trying to make this as long as possible.
Oh, God. Finally!
Can he get
Alright. Now we're gonna. Now we're getting in.
Lucky box.
So. Hello. Thank you, Backseat Bull Rage. We're saying he has to go, but he wants to waste time. In yeah, exactly. I need to go. But now you wanna waste time. You wanna do down four, down four, down four, down four. Whatever, man. Whatever. So this is definitely gonna be very interesting. Woo!
You said these guys play each other a lot, right?
Yeah. I don't know if it's like a lot now. Definitely back when, I guess it was quite a lot. Well, quite a bit. So
they definitely have some notes on each other.
Yeah, they know each other. They know each other. So here we go. It's gonna be very interesting.
Do you reckon we're gonna see Bullridge as the main team off the bat, or is he gonna pick someone else?
I don't know, actually. This is going to be very interesting, actually. It's going to be very interesting, because maybe, I know Bullrage hasn't been, he's only like recently come back online, so maybe he actually doesn't know Rail's improvement, so maybe he may pick,
oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, so maybe he may pick a team, and he may regret picking the team, who knows, so, or maybe he just knows, okay, I have to play this guy, seriously, he knows how to play. Because yeah. I know personally the role does know how to play the game.
Get ready for the so, next battle.
Yep.
Big guard. Off the bat.
Yep. Big guard.
No cheeky Dr. B's.
No. This is definitely going to be... This is going to be a good one to watch.
Yeah, for sure. We got Vendetta and Transformers.
Round one.
Oh, shit. Sure.
Whoa. Okay. That was an interesting choice to start off with.
What the fuck? Sorry, I think this game's messed up on my end.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, what's going on? Sorry. Fuck. This stream is really going crazy on my end. Is that going in slow motion?
Oh, yeah, I see that. That's weird.
Oh, God, hold on. Alright, I think it's back now. Alright, guys, calm down. I'm gonna really fix this really quick. Hold on.
Is it going slow mo for you on the...
Like, yeah, no, it's something's going... My capture card's going hell. Hold on.
Okay.
Alright, guys, don't worry. I'm gonna try to fix this really quick. 2 seconds, guys. I'm gonna just restart the stream real
quick. Yeah, that's it.
So. Yeah, so I'm really sorry about that, guys. We're back now. Lucky Roll has taken the lead in the first round, and he's about to take the second round. Anything shouldn't happen.
Oh.
Nah,
almost.
I'm really sorry about that, guys. People should show more love to Mac and develop software properly. But yeah. So we got Bull Rage now. He is a combo expert.
Oh, is that gonna be it? Oh, that could have been it.
Woo! Gets a hit on the way out. But we got Rel coming in, nice full crowd sweep. You're a Miguel master yourself.
Well, I wouldn't say a master, but yeah, I'm playing.
He's so humble. So we got nice space in here by Rel. Nice block on the fourth board one.
Yeah, very good move.
Yeah, he's very patient. Yeah, he knows when to press buttons, and he's played against my Jack a lot. I do rinse Jack against him a lot, so I know a thing or two about Jack myself, so he's probably learned a thing or two as well when fighting against Jack. But we've got Bullrage now on the offense. Rel's playing really patient at the moment. He's two rounds up. I guess, you know, he can use his match to get some knowledge. Yeah, you know. He was a losing cause that match. But now Got Steve. Whoa, Steve versus Steve. That's gonna be interesting. Who's gonna get that back one? Ooh, doesn't punish the back two.
He's been doing that a lot.
There we go.
Going into Pikachu and doing lost any too.
Unlucky there. I don't know why that combo didn't hit. Ooh, nice. That's a lucky, nice and lucky tag in now. This scrap is a bad position to be in. Ooh, step to down back. Yeah, he could definitely could have got launched there. Ooh, Tombstone is going to do mega chunk. What's the Okazemi? Ops to roll back. Ooh, that's minus 17. I don't think Miguel can get a solid punish on that. Maybe down 1 plus 2.
I mean, worst case, he gets down 4. Down 1 plus 2, I'm pretty sure it's too slow, but I think he should be able to get a back 4.
Okay. That's a nice hop kick right there. And but unfortunately, now his back is against the wall. Nice,
yeah,
down
2-1.
And I think he could have ended that. Doesn't Steve get something guaranteed off of a down back 2?
Yeah, I think he gets the, what's it called, Albatross down to whoever, the spin.
Oh, no, that was an excellent read there on the tag in. That was beautiful. So, Bull Rage there showing he has knowledge. So, Bull Rage bringing it back 2 rounds, so it's both 2-2. Lovely. Rel's throw breaking is really impressive. I would actually put his throw breaking maybe second or third best in the UK, and that is honest true. Wow, just walks into the pink piston. Unlucky there on the combo. Ooh, could have sonic banned that and I would have splat on the wall. That's an unlucky, well, lucky tagging for Bullridge, unlucky for Rel there.
I'm just gonna, he takes it.
Yeah, the down back one to the down four, that's my special. Bullridge, stop copying me.
Old faithful.
So, that was a very interesting match. Bull Rage was 2 rounds down there and managed to bring it back, but it wasn't. That match was by no means one-sided at all. That was not one-sided.
Not at all.
Rel showing he has strong throw breaking, strong fundamentals there. And Bull Rage obviously being Bull Rage showing that he knows his character, knows Steve. To be honest, I don't actually think I could say what anyone could actually do better. They played well.
When Steve goes into Peek and Boo, you can beat all his options by just sidestepping left and ducking, but
yeah,
Forge has been doing a lot of while standing two out of it.
Yeah, that's a Bull Rage special. One thing he likes to do. I notice when he goes into duck, he likes to do while standing two, and why not? It is a counter hit launcher. It's safe. So,
yeah, it's a very good move.
Yeah, very underused move. So we got Bull Rage 1 round up. We got. Someone, I don't think Rel will change teams. I do reckon this is his best team. I know he has a horror.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's gonna change teams, to be honest.
So, I wonder if Rel's just taking time on the character select screen just to
get ready for the next battle.
Recoup thoughts. So yeah, we're going back in. The Bull Rage is probably choosing another custom because this guy likes to dress up Steve and everything. Yeah, Rel is playing very well. I don't know why you're in the chat telling him that. You should be friggin' concentrating on your match.
Round 1.
So we go. Starts off with the up 1. Nice punish on the back 2.
Yep.
Goes to the punch pad. That's interesting, actually. We go. He's in. Guess that was alright.
Oh.
Wow, that's the second time that's happened. He's got the first hit and he's been tagged by the second hit. Unlucky. Just falls short of the wall there. So now they're just playing the patient spacing game. Ducked that. But could have got a little bit more, I guess. And now we've got Rage Jacket, lovely punish from the debugger.
Yeah, to be honest, against Steve, throwing out Twin Pistons isn't like the end of the world. Like,
yeah,
worst case, you're just going to eat Sonic Fang, really.
That's a nice reversal on the tackle as well.
Yep.
We've got Jacket. I don't know what kind of custom Jacket is. That looks like maybe Captain Scarlet. I don't know.
I have no.
So, a few whiffs there, whiffs down for 2, nice up punch. And that's one thing that I think Miguel players should use a lot against Jack, the up forward 1. Like, obviously not all the time because you can get floated out of it, but it is a good option against Jack because Jack can't step it. Another one is back three. Very good. So we got with the down 3-2 from Bull Rage. We got Miguel. That's very nice. He's pressured, but he's using spacing and stepping and blocking to get out of that bad situation against the wall. I guess the
he's not pushing buttons because he knows.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Bro definitely knows how to play. He knows when to press buttons. Nice. Beautiful. He saw that. Oh, unlucky. He went for the duck three there, but sometimes you press it too fast, you get a grab. That's unlucky there. Shouldn't get disheartened. Nice throw break. I'm telling you, this guy's throw break. His throw breaking is, I think, near par to menace. Ooh, unlucky on the punish there. He gets one hit, but the second hit whiffs. Nice punish from Bull Rage. He's going to have to find a way to get Miguel in. Comes in with the savage stance. So I guess that's a nice tag cancel there. So, in my personal opinion, Miguel versus Jack is really in Miguel's favour. Astim has shown, I've played this match with Astim plenty of times, and he's shown me why Jack sucks against Miguel.
Was it the hit? Step, or is there anything else?
I don't want to, I will say things after the match. And that wasn't actually a combo.
Okay.
I don't want to say it, and then I start seeing the stuff getting spammed. Ooh, gets the launch there. Is this going to go to the wall? Ooh, unlucky there. The down back 3-2, goes to the albatross. Down two, and Jack against the wall is bad. It's bad news. That was a nice tag against the wall. Taggings are really unpredictable.
I should have. Oh wow!
Nice throw break. I'm telling you. I told you. I really rate this Rel's throw breaking. I really, when I say it's not a lie, his throw breaking, I really think is second to Menace, second or third.
Yeah.
It is really rapid. It is really good. It's 1-1. This match, I told you, this match is definitely going to be one to watch.
What's your prediction?
I can't say. I know what I think is going to happen in this match, and I don't want to say it. I don't want to upset no one.
All right.
It's a lose-lose situation.
Don't want to take sides. Don't blame
me. Yeah, I don't want to take sides. But I do think I know what's going to happen. So, I wonder if what Bull Rage is doing. What's he doing? Is he going to think? Is he going to change character? Maybe go to Dr. B and molest an unknown wild card.
Do you think he's gonna risk it and switch teams?
Who knows? Well, if he does, I guess he's got one more match to go back. His Dr. B did work well against Domination. I can't remember. Sorry, mate.
Finger Demolition.
So yeah. Is definitely a really tight match. I knew from when I saw the brackets, I wanted this match to happen. From when Ro actually told me he may be facing Bull Rage. He switched teams. Wow.
Okay, so he does go for it.
He's gone for the Ganryu and Lei.
Do you think Rel knows these characters?
I know Rel plays Lei. I know that. And he plays against someone who plays Ganny. Round one. So it's not like he doesn't have the experience, but Bull Rage, his gameplay, and Ganryu, I've often had trouble with it. So we'll see how he can deal with it. Nice throw from Peekaboo, 10 count, doesn't get broken by Bull Rage. I guess with Ganryu, he just really wants to poke away and get the heavy hits. Brings in Lei and tags him. Forward 3 gets blocked. So it's... he walks. See, I think Rel knows Lei, because I know he was really studying Lei for a bit, so I guess he knows when to duck, when to step.
Yeah.
So it'll be very interesting. Nice punish on the down 3. Forward 3 again. He goes to the forward 3. This is actually quite intense. This is quite up close action, and Oh, the life bars are really even. I don't even know how to commentate this. Oh, nice running three there. So, goes to the back cart. Ooh, just gets clapped with a back one. Count hit. This isn't going to kill, but it's going to do damage.
Ooh, just about.
I don't agree with the running two ender. Yeah. He shouldn't have done the running two ender. If I was him, I would have done up forward one because it had more recovery.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it would have been right to bait the tag crash, but tag crash is Miguel in now and gets slapped for his troubles. And now we've got the Ganryu presser. So Ganryu definitely, I know. Ooh.
Oh gosh.
Wow, he's sent him up. So yeah, I know Bulbe definitely has a different style with Ganryu. He brings his aggressive Steve style to Ganryu, and that was a nice throw break by Well, breaking another throw. Oh, nice punch. Oh, why would Bulbe hit buttons after that to get counter hit? I don't know. Wow, that is unpunishable, but
goes for full. Can reach Savage T with a jab, but it is minus 10.
Or
is not spreading stuff where people score.
So you got Miguel's Lei in stance, and Lei is a character that I actually don't know. I don't get frustrated when playing Lei, but I just don't know his stance. The nice back 1+2 there, catching that can't hit. That 1+2 with Miguel is actually really good. It's 11 frames,
yeah,
right?
It's 11. Yes.
Yeah. And it is basically like a, well, it doesn't have the meaty hitbox of the Steve back one, but it does have its uses and breaks the freeway throw. Three options out of that. Ooh, what's a hot kick.
Bit late on the whip button.
Yeah. Nice block there. Rel's playing really solid and throws out a hop kick there, trying to catch him running in, I think. But he's got the life deficit, so he needs to make something happen right now. And Bulbe is just backing up.
To do it.
Yeah, I don't think so. Hitboxes.
That was heartbreaking.
Had he
gotten that bound, that would have been the round.
Yeah, he just misjudged the wall there. Definitely misjudged the wall. Yeah. And I know Steve, yeah, definitely. We got the bound then, got the wall combo. Steve's quarter circle forward one, back 1-1-1-2 does hella damage.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
But right now, the biggest issue is going to be dealing with Ganryu.
Yeah, I know. I played Bull Rage's Ganryu, and I know it is a problem. I know, I know Rel has played against Ganryu, but maybe not to maybe a level of Bull Rage and a playstyle of Bull Rage, because he definitely really rushes down with Ganny. He pokes you and pokes you, and he'll poke you again and again. And if you hit him, he'll come back and he'll poke you again. So it is definitely going to be really, really interesting to see how he's going to make adjustments for this.
You reckon Rel's going to switch? Because this is his last switch.
Nah, I reckon. I don't think he will switch. This is his strongest team, and I think he knows this is his strongest team. He does. He has been playing Harang, but Bull Rage knows Harang that quite well. Bull Rage plays Harang. I just think he should continue doing what he's doing, because it's not like I wouldn't say he's getting run over. He knows how to play the game and he's fundamentally solid. So fundamentally,
yeah, definitely. You can definitely tell he knows what he's doing. His fundamentals are really, really good.
Yeah. Ooh, so this is going to be very, very, very interesting. So what could potentially be the final game if Bull Rage wins, or is Rel going to bring it back and make it a tag battle? So here we go, we've got a wall of stage. Ganryu, if he gets you back against the wall with that down back three or down forward three, that move is just hella annoying at the wall. We get hit with a stop sign that says no while standing four. Goes for the clap to catch the tag in, and now we got Rage Steve. Ooh, gets that. I don't know what the notation is for that, but that move's annoying.
Yeah, that's nice.
Unlucky on the forward 4-2 there. Full rage with the sweep. Doesn't go for the attack assault.
Oh, trying to go for the setup.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe. I don't know what that was. Maybe it was a setup. Nice step. Hot kick. And. Bring down.
I think we should end with 4-1. Oh, never mind.
Oh, I don't know that. Ah, boy, launched that, yeah. But I guess, I don't know. She got Haha step in, and this boy is playing an evasive game now. Yeah, he's looking.
So
to
scary trying to whip punish the way because there's always some follow up.
Yeah, ooh, tries to catch the counter hit. So we've got 15 seconds. Most of these matches have actually gone down to time. Ooh, in the back of the head, that
ooh,
donkey punch.
He's in trouble.
Ooh, nice unlucky, low parry. Bull rage is well, that's one of Bull Rage's specialities, low. I don't know about the life. Oh, nice, yeah, it's definitely over. That jab killed it. Wow. Ooh, doesn't step it. I wonder if Steve can punch parry the second hit of Ganryu's back 2-1-2. Wow! Gets a counter hit, doesn't confirm. Comes in laying down. Nice option there, down back 2. Ooh. Go for a down two. I wonder if he went for a down back two again, but just got a down two. Gets a sweep. Gonna go for tag assault. I don't agree with that tag assault, because now Miguel is X Factor level 3. Ooh, gets caught with
the...
Yeah. That low is annoying. Ooh, he went for it again. Oh, unlucky on the combo there. May have been a little off axis. I'm not sure why that whiffed. Doesn't punish the forward 4-2. Alright. Ooh, he rolled back.
I think that was meant to be 7 down 4-2. Oh, I get stopped by 4-4-3.
I don't think this is going to kill.
No.
Oh, that was actually a combo. Wow. Unblockable charge combos, yeah?
That's crazy.
So we got... So this is... Yeah, this is where it gets really hard to play against Lei. When Lei has the life lead like that, and you need to approach him, he's got that stance laying down.
Ooh,
that's
very
nice
duck, too.
Nice.
Well, we've had the situation like several times now where he doesn't have the life lead and he only has like 15 seconds left to do something about
it. Most of these matches have gone down to that the last seconds, definitely. Ooh, he catches him stepping there with the wild side in 3. We could have ducked that the second hit, I think.
Yeah.
Ooh, so Merle's just playing very patient still. That's good. He's not throwing anything.
I think Borage is exploiting his patience a bit. Like he's not finishing a lot of strings and just going into more pressure. Oh, took your nice stuff for
him. That was nice. Got the last lead quite handy. So I guess nice punish on the headbutt. That was a beautiful punish on the headbutt. No, you can't let Ganryu get away with headbutts. Came in with the savage stance there and blocked the downfall too. So he just needs
to close this out right now.
Yeah, he's looking to really end this full rage. Okay, that's a nice tag in, brings in Steve, a healthier Steve, while running too, sorry, my bad. Ooh, this is a nice step. Oh, I don't know what's gonna happen. By 2%.
Oh my god.
Nah, this is.
These rounds are just going to the wire.
Yeah, every round's gone to the wire. Nice, while standing 1-2, punish there. Goes for the up forward 1+2. Steps there, but doesn't get a legit punish. Nice roll break there. He's very on point. I told you, his roll breaking is very impressive.
Yeah, for sure.
We got Bull Rage just throwing stuff out of range. Ooh.
Oh, no punish.
Ooh, I wonder if he's trying to make Ganryu not leave the scene, and that's why he kept on doing down forward one.
Yeah. That's what we're for.
Yeah. Ooh, that's counter hit. That's guaranteed. Yeah, good option. Ooh, unlucky with the down back two there. Ooh, nice throw break there. Oh, these two are really playing on point. Nice. Unlucky with a 4-4-2. So, we got a little bit. I don't want them to start panicking now. Ooh, back dash is that. Go for the down 4-2, try catch him stepping.
Oh, no, definitely.
Gets the float.
Gets the float.
Well, I guess any damage is some damage.
He needs to go in now. He doesn't have the time.
Yeah, ooh, yeah, nice run into. Okay. Oh, not now. That's
yeah. Well, lagging for you as well. Down back two. Is he gonna catch him on the way out?
Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. Do it. No. Let's go again! He just got down to the wire again! This match is hot! Get hype, guys! This match is fucking sick!
Oh my god!
Get slapped to the floor. Nice, he's very nice patience there to get off the ground. So, Gary, you know, Boorage is making his Gary run in and. Unlucky right there. I'm not gonna go down for it too. Gets the big boot. Shout out to the Undertaker. So, though Boorage has to lead this match can still go any way.
Yeah. I mean, he needs to find. Okay, he did just find a way for Lay to come back in.
Steve's in now. And I wonder how Steve deals with all Lay's options if he tries to go. Oh, that's in the back.
Oh, that could have gone way worse.
Yeah. Ooh, goes to the evasive.
I wonder if Steve can punish that.
Maybe Sonic. Oh, this
ooh,
is gonna
can
be
I go for it? That is. That is unfortunate.
That's heartbreaking. That match was. That was really good, guys.
Yeah. That was sick.
That match. That was of high level.
Yep.
That match was definitely of high level. That was very high level play. GG's to the ball for you. guys, that was that was really beautiful Tekken. I really enjoyed that match.
That was my favorite set in development so far.
That was really enjoyed, man.
I think Tyrell was just too passive.
Definitely. I think he was a bit passive, but I think that's kind of like his playstyle.
But I mean, like Bullrage was. I think Bullrage was really exploiting the fact that, from what I see at least, Rel tends to wait for its strings to finish.
Yeah.
So Bullrage will just do a bunch of strings and not end them, and just keep pressuring him.
Hmm.
Because I mean, Bullrage was whiffing from medium range, but it was never really anything big. Like every time he would have tried to lift punish, he would have risked getting counter hit.
So we have Bullrage moving on, and Rose gonna be sent to losers, but definitely not someone to sleep on. I expect to see him power make impact in losers. Definitely. Really impressive play. So. So are we gonna get who played before and the match was laggy?
It was Armand and who was it? It was the Spanish guy, C3D or something.